Hi, my name is Jason Koo, a developer advocate here at Always AI, and today I'm going to talk about the high-level technical workflow and technical requirements required to leverage Always AI's computer vision platform. The Always AI platform can be segmented into three elements: the model catalog, a Python library, and command line tools to, in combination, help accelerate your computer vision development. Now, the model catalog is a curated list of computer vision models, from image classifiers to object detection models and a pose estimator. These models can be used to quickly prototype an idea or even to build your entire end product from. The second element is the Edge IQ Python library. Now, this library of ours is built on top of OpenCV, and it basically makes CV development a little bit easier by reducing the code burden and should make your implementation a little bit faster and reduce the number of lines of code required to get a computer vision app up and running. The third element is the command line tools that you can use from a development machine to quickly build and package your application into a Docker container and then push it out directly to an edge device that can support Docker. Okay, so the workflow, the development workflow you need to go for creating an application using our platform, you have a number of different options. The first option is if you have a Linux or a Windows system, you can build natively right onto that system. Granted, your computer has a built-in webcam or you have an attached webcam. So hardware-wise, you're going to need a webcam or a camera to make use of computer vision live. But if you can, of course, use our platform to process video that's already completed. So if you're planning on capturing real-time video, I'm going to assume you have a camera attached. Otherwise, you can process video that's been pre-recorded by some other source. Okay, so back to our workflow. So again, if you have a Linux or a Windows system, you can build right onto that and test it out and get up and running. The second option is to take an edge device like a Raspberry Pi, a Jetson Nano, a Qualcomm board, and build and deploy right onto that device directly. So you can put all our tooling on there, put Docker on there, so you can do all your development from the machine and then deploy it to itself and then run from there. The third option that is most prescribed is to have two separate machines, right? You have a development machine that's your workhorse, it's a little more horsepower. You put all the tooling onto the development machine, and then when you're ready, you push the app using our CLI tool to the edge device or edge devices that you plan on using. This is a little more flexible because this is kind of more reflective of what you would do for an actual production type setting, because you wouldn't necessarily want to put all our tooling onto the edge device. So the first thing you need to do is you need to have a valid account with Always AI. So you can go down to the bottom of this page and you'll see a link for signing up if you're not signed up already. After you have an account, hardware-wise, again, we mentioned you need either a Linux or a Windows machine if you want to develop directly on those systems. Or if you're like me who has an Apple device, you'll need to run a VM to deploy directly to itself. Or you have an actual edge device that you have while you're developing that you can push to actually test and run your application. So hardware-wise, that this is kind of the combinations. You have some development machine, Linux, Windows, Mac with VM, and or an edge device. So those are the hardware requirements. The software requirements for running Always AI is a two-part. The development machine requires Node and NPM. You will use NPM on the development machine to install the Python library and also the CLI tooling. And the edge device just needs to be able to run Docker, whether it's running a chipset of ARM32, ARM64, x86. Again, if you're gonna do everything on just an edge device or just on your laptop, then you kind of have both requirements on that one device. So that's it. That's all you need to get up and running. If you need additional info and next steps, they will be at the bottom of the page. And if you need additional technical help, you can go to our Slack community workspace, which you'll be granted access to when you sign up. And we are very excited to hear about what you're working on.